Hey, and welcome back. Okay, the last time we did this island here, and we managed, well, we lost our pilot, which is really a shame, and had a very rough start, kind of. It's kind of my fault, really. But after that, it got better, and we finished the island, got a few upgrades for our team here. I'm really happy with my team. I don't like having only free movement here, but we have already maxed out our thing here, so we are not gonna be doing anything there. Got free damage and the tank, and here we have, yeah, I think we have a very good team. I like the teleport range. The range here is really, I mean, look at this crap here. I can teleport from here. Wait, I can't even teleport from... Well, maybe I can't. But that's pretty nice. That's yeah, that's really good. Let's leave the island and go for the last one, which is a bit nasty. But now I have ways to deal with the digger guy. I can freeze him, for example. I can use that. Let me test that, actually. Yeah, it's kind of nice. And you can... Look at this crap. Wow. Can freeze everything, man. It's kind of crazy, so I would love to use that. I never had the ice generator before, so I'm looking forward to that. Okay, here where we want to do is we have to get more power grid. We took a few shots to the face, so this seems like a good thing to start. Okay, I like the firefly. It's usually a very favorable enemy. Actually, they are all pretty good enemies for me. And now my whole team can fly, which is very nice. Okay, what I want to do here is I want to make them attack this here. Then I can go one tile here and they hit the mountain. And that's perfect. Artillery is in a good position. It can do some good damage, actually. Yeah, it's not bad. Having that here. Also very easy to defend. Nobody will get that. And yeah, let's go. If I keep my tank... wow, another port. Good. If I keep him centrally, I should be able to get where I need to go. Even though I only have free movement. That being said, that's a bit nasty. That's a bit nasty, actually. It's a bit... Shit. Yeah, the movement is a problem, kind of, on my team. Damn. I mean, two of the enemies are not doing anything special. And that's okay, right? Oh, my new weapon is gonna... Oh my god, that's beautiful. That's absolutely beautiful. I can just one-shot that guy. And do 5 damage and push him out of the way. Oh my god. What I also think I will do is I will kind of take a shot here. Before I do that. Is there any better way to deal with that? I don't think there is a better way to deal with that. So I'm gonna... I mean, there might be, who knows, but... I can take a shot here. Do I want to tank a shot here? Eh, not really. I have a really beautiful way to do that here. This way I'm not really blocking any spawns, but... Oh, no, that's a bad idea, because he will hit that building. Last episode I would have missed that. He shoots here, he hits this three, yeah. But the idea is, okay. Okay. I can do it here and that's fine. I have a range to do that. Put acid on that guy. Is it the best thing to do? I'm not sure. I could just take a shot here, but I can't get there, is the thing, and... I could teleport my guy here, put him here and take a shot. Will do 3 damage to him, almost kill him. Alternatively, I could... Yeah, I think that's better, huh? Putting that guy here so he can block a spawn. But I would need to... I can tank a shot from that guy, it's only 1 damage, 2 damage. It's not the end of the world, really. Or I could get the tank out, my tank out. Nah, screw that. Oh, it's gonna be... gonna put me on fire. Never mind. I still think it's the plan is okay, but... What if I do the acid? What if I do the acid? Put my tank here? Yeah, no. Because that guy will kill me. No, he won't kill me. Yeah, he will kill me. No, he won't kill me. What am I doing anyway? I don't know what I'm doing. Wanted to push him here and then push him here, but he will kill my guy. I only have 2 health. So that's not really gonna work. Putting myself on fire is not great either. Sure. Maybe just... Who cares if I'm on fire? Do I care if I'm on fire? I'll just kill that guy, maybe. It's a nasty guy. Why not kill him? Just keep it simple. Not a bad move, I mean. That guy will be on acid. That's okay. 4 enemies, but I have 5 units potentially if I get my tank out. And a Psion. Healing them 1 each turn. Not a big deal, really. Yeah, okay, they are all being nasty, but... Unfortunately, that's not enough to do that. That's a beautiful shot, I think I will do that shot. However, we still need to... deal with all of that crap here. Not sure how. Could do that, acid him, kill him. And... Yeah, the 5 health is really nice, kind of. Just put that guy like that, maybe. Maybe deploy my tank and push him out of the way and... That's probably a good idea. Yeah. I like my team. It was rough in the beginning, but now I like my team a lot. I got HP. Cool, I got HP. Okay, where do I want to push him? Doesn't really matter. I think into the mountain would be okay. Yeah, and remember, like last episode, I only had like 2 health on my guys. Now they all have 4 health or 5 health. Completely fine. Block them. Yeah, now I can block spawns without dying immediately. And I like my team. I really do like my team now. Oh, we have 2 turns left. I didn't quite realize that. Okay. Man, I like my team. It's a nice team. I could mess with them. Sure. I think just kill them. Oh, I can only use that once per battle. Ah! I got a bit carried away there, apparently. Okay. My fault. But That's my mistake. Okay. Who can move? You can. Okay. I can just freeze them next turn. And because, you know, it'll be over. I don't have to move my jet mech anymore. Ooh, that's nasty. That's okay. That's only two enemies. It's, okay, I need to put. I can use it twice, right? Oh, I didn't. I think I can make so it does two uses of that. Oh no, I think I did that twice already, huh? Huh. That's funny. Yeah, it's really kind of. Maybe it might be better to put the tank on her. We need to think about that again. Not sure. Experience? Yeah, Ariadna needs experience. But she won't get any experience, so. Maybe she will. Nah, she won't. Yeah, here we go. One more experience, why not? So I can use that twice and I can freeze myself. If I put more cores into the freeze, I can do something productive on every turn at least. Time port. Chen Rong, after attacking gain one free tile movement. Why do they all have grid defense for the skill? That's really bad. But I can get two reputation for her. So that's not too bad. Don't think I will use her because my pilots have better skills, like HP and mech reactors and crap like that. I can use it only twice. And I can only use the ice generator once. So that's. What if I switch that? What if I switch that around, huh? What happens then? Give the tank to Ariadne. Let's test that really quickly. If you think about it, the melee, the tank is close by anyway, meaning that he's more in a position to use that in a good way, maybe. And now I have more size. Only free movement, but flying, I have flying. I can take away flying and give one more movement, but I think flying might be better. Or I could do that and take a movement here. I wonder what's better. I'm not sure. I think I'll take that. So if I can't attack anybody or whatever, I can do that. And she has a tank. So once I shoot that, I can use the tank, deploy the tank. That might be good. And this way I can give the tank two more damage. So I think that works out pretty well. Okay, now Colonial Park. Defend the tanks. Ugh, it tends to be a bit ugly. But we can freeze people. So how bad can it be? How bad can it really be? Ooh, quite bad. Potentially quite bad, but it's only three enemies that can do anything. There's no spider. I forgot if there is any spider on that. I don't think there is a spider. I think no spider. Maybe do that so I have a clear shot. Do that so I can freeze people if I want to, and here I can teleport them in the water. For example, if that guy goes like here, 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 whatever. Actually, if I don't allow him to grab me. Yeah, okay, if he grabs me, right, if he goes here, grabs me, I go here, teleport him into the water. It's not really a problem. Okay, let's go. The thing is, if you have enough damage, the Psion is really not that important. I mean, he can heal them, yeah, but. You see what I meant, like why I need artillery to reach him? If I didn't have a teleport now, I would need to use two actions to get the stone out of the way, to move into position, to shoot. But remember when I started my team, my tank was doing one damage, my jetpack was doing one damage. And now we have like 5 damage and 3 damage and ice generator and tank, and it's really nice, really. I like it. That's bad. No, I think this will happen regardless. Teleport an alpha digger into the water. That has to happen. I would love to teleport that guy as well, but I can't kill him outright. And then we need to deal with that guy. Okay, let's do that. If I could deploy the tank and push him here, that would be nice, but I can't. And to and push that guy out of the way. I don't think we'll do the ice generator yet. Man, 5 damage is really nice. Holy shit. And even with 3 damage like that is pretty cool. If nothing strange happens, we should be making good progress here. I think I'll play in this episode, I'll play till the finish. And next turn I will be able to use the tanks. I have to be careful that I don't shove them in the water by accident. Could happen. Could happen. Okay, now might be time to deploy the tank. I think. Now I can't stand here because I would take damage if I do it like that. But I can just kill. And the Psion, who cares? Yeah, it's not doing anything. And all the tanks can move. Really, I shouldn't even block the spawns. I need the experience points. I need to get a level for my friend here. Maybe kill the Firefly. It has, what, 5 health? We can take care of 5 health. No big problem. We can just do that. Yeah, why not? She will get that pretty quickly, I think. The tanks here look the same as my tank. Why do the tanks have more movement than my tank? What the hell is going on? That's my tank, right? I should, yeah, if I mix them up and kill the wrong tank. Support tank, archive tank. Yeah. Okay. Now that guy, I don't have to block every spawn, really. Let's allow one spawn. In fact, let's like, maybe, yeah, it's too late. Let's allow two, well, although she can't get experience anymore, she used the shots already. Let's allow 2 spawns though, it's, why not? I'm not killing my important guy, right? Make double sure, I don't want to screw that up. Don't want to lose the objective because I killed the tank. Like an idiot. No, that's not what we want. Let's try out the freeze. I don't think I can kill anything. I can't kill stuff here. If I want to. Now she can't do anything, so let's move her out of the way. So we... That guy is in the way, kind of. Okay, I can teleport him. Like that. It's pretty funny, actually. But I don't need the experience on that. Can get one more kill. One experience, yay! And just for fun. Hey, that went fairly well, I think. Yeah, really happy with that. No, it's a hard mission. Ooh, defend the train, but with an extra... Okay, can we do that? Kill 7, let's do that first, and then go for that. Just kind of warm up a little bit, I suppose. Yeah, with the freeze, with the ice generator, I'm feeling fairly confident about my ability to do that. Okay, I don't want the digger to attack me, because if he goes here, I can teleport him in the water. If he, yeah, although if he goes like here, then I can't do that. And if he goes here now, I can just one shot him. So maybe that's better, huh? Yeah, it might be better. Let's do that. So maybe that guy will. Who moves first? No. What's gonna happen is he's gonna go here and get that, and this guy will shoot something else by default. Okay, fine. So I need to kill them, so I shouldn't block too many spawns. I shouldn't use the ice generator, because then I can't kill them, and if they are frozen, they actually block new spawns. So any frozen target counts as an enemy, and if you have too many enemies, there won't be new spawns. Okay, so he's gonna die. Actually, let's do it. Okay, that tank. Okay, I got my. I think I know what I want to do. Okay, that's a pretty nice turn, I think. Come at me, guys. Get over here. Okay. He is gone. He is gone. He is gone. So be careful that I don't damage anything. I'm getting a bit too cocky. That's dangerous. He's a bit more experienced, but I don't need free spawns. Two spawns are enough. I kill one more guy and that's it. Yeah. Oh, all that for good defense. You have to be kidding me, man. That's stupid. That's really stupid. That's really dumb. I think everybody has good defense now. Man, ruined a good pilot like that. He's still good, don't get me wrong, but could have been better. Yeah. Okay, I think we can defend the train. And we have to look out for... might be able to find another strange port in the mountain. I'm not used to paying attention to that, but it could happen again. So we might... Oh yeah, no buildings here. Okay, there's no port or anything. Okay. So two hornets, which is not great, but no spiders, no scorpions, yeah. Man, they are all elite. Everybody's elite. Very fancy. Now if I could just freeze all of them, all of these bastards. I think, by the way, you can freeze the train. And it still counts, even though it's frozen. I think... I'm not sure I'm willing to try that, okay? But... I think that's how it works, maybe? Let's go here, because this doesn't really help me. I want that guy to attack somewhere where it doesn't really matter. So here, for example, it's only free movement. Yeah, let's go here. Let's go like that. Let's go like that. He might attack here. Takes care of that. And these guys I can just kill, and that guy I can maybe teleport in the water. Maybe. Let's go. Okay, we got a normal port, that's okay. Yeah, these special ports, they usually contain very good pilots, I think. Oh, that's a nasty spawn. That's very nasty. That's very nasty. Holy shit, that's nasty. Not even sure. Yeah, okay. Man, the teleport is amazing. I can get rid of a guy who is otherwise extremely nasty. Very nasty opponent. Very nasty. Very, very nasty. Now, we could push that guy into death. We can do that. Tank the shot, push him in the water, he's gonna die. Teleport him in the water, he will die, and we can do that after that. That guy is attacking nothing, and here I can deploy my tank and make them attack each other, or I can take him, kill them outright. I could also freeze everybody. Let me see if that could, would that work if I do that? Well, I... that would be... If that worked, that would be... Let's test that, okay? Maybe take the port. I don't want to test that. If it doesn't work, you know, I already lost a train mission because I tried something that I read on the internet and it backfired really hard. So I don't want to do that, but I think you can freeze the tank, the train, and it will be fine, even though it can't move anymore. Anyway, I think I will deploy my... Yeah, and they attack each other, and that's good. They attack each other. He attacks me, it's 2 damage, not great, but it's okay. And we got the port. Yeah. But maybe somebody will go into the acid and do me a favor. And I have 2 shots left on my good weapon. Oh yeah, he did that. Very nice. Oh. It's a bit nasty, really, but okay. So I can kill these 2 jokers. I can't quite... I think that... yeah, I guess the question is, what's more annoying, the digger or the hornet? Don't really know the answer to that. I think I might use my freeze here. I do that, and then the spawn will get me out of that. Why not? Don't have to do it like that, but I don't know. Why not? It's pretty cool. Let's do it. It's a bit of a waste, but do it anyway. Let me get in a better position here. Yeah, I like it. It's really powerful. I mean, I didn't need to do that, but... You know, I put some points into that. Would be a shame not to use that, I suppose. Yeah, getting that grid on my guy was a bit annoying, but okay. We will survive it, I suppose. It's okay. Oh, I think now we have a boss coming, right? Boss fight. What did we get? Yeah, no need for that. We can sell that. Too expensive. Wrong. No matching mech class. Would be okay. But no need. Well, we got two cores. What do we want to do with that? We can almost do the damage here. Almost can do the damage. Well, let's do that, more movement, and next time we... Yeah, I can't put anything here anymore, so that's not gonna happen. Would be nice, like movement and mech reactor. Would be perfect. But he got, yeah... Got the wrong stuff. Damage, yeah, I want the damage. Can maybe one-shot the boss, if I'm lucky. Yeah, she also has good defense. Man. Okay, spider leader. Ooh, spider leader. Eee. Man, I really want damage. If I had a tank with damage, ooh, I could really hit them. Could really hit these bastards really hard, but... I would have to take off the use, maybe, and I think that's more useful than 2 damage on a tank. Maybe debatable. But I think I'll go like that. Let's go. And by the way, you can't kill a boss with water. Yeah. Okay, that guy... knee. Maybe like that. I really want to hit the boss. And this guy can maybe... Like, if he shoots at me, I can't put him in the water. I need him essentially to go for... To stay on that... Line here. On the four... There's a word for that. Column? I don't know. If he stays here, or if he goes here even, but why would he go here? Yeah, he might go for that or that. Then I can kill him. And otherwise, I'll just... Yeah, I don't know how that's gonna play out. This guy might go here, and if I have that guy here, I could get a very easy kill. But I can teleport, yeah, okay, I think I can deal with that, no matter what happens. Having flying on all my guys is really good. Especially with all the enemies in between, yeah, it's, for example, now I can go here and shoot, okay, I can't, but I can go here and shoot the boss. Which otherwise I couldn't do, and that guy has no target. That's nice. Yeah, I thought he might do it like that. Can I reach that? I can reach that guy. He's gone. He's gone. The spider is being a bit of a bastard about that whole thing. I can do that, but it would push the spider in the building, and I could freeze everybody, but I have to kill the boss. So that's no good. Okay, so the spider here we can ignore, yeah? That's clear. I'm thinking 1, 2, 3, 4, okay. Yeah, I don't know. I wonder if I should just freeze everybody and... It's kind of stupid. Freeze everybody with the exception of a boss. Kill the spider. I can kill the spider in any way I want. can deploy a tank, I can push that into that and they both die. But I wonder if that's really necessary. And I think maybe not. One thing I hate is that I don't see a good way to deal with that. Just it's awkward. And I don't want to use a shot like that to kill the freaking spider. But that's the only way I see that happening. Or I could do this shot. It would kill everything pretty much. And then I can teleport the firefly. It wouldn't do much damage to the boss. But maybe that's okay. Yeah, come on. Let's do that. Free damage. It's a good, yeah. It's a good opening. With two spiders left. We'll have two spiders. Ugh, a hornet. But the boss is gonna die, I think. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Come here, spider. Yep, good. Okay. And I have flying so I can. Oh man. So it's going down, but he's being a prick about it, essentially. Okay. Yeah, all the spiders here are being a bit annoying. I can just do that, huh? Doesn't really matter. One more spawn. We can deal with one more spawn. Okay, they are really being helpful about all that. Let's do the freeze, I feel like it. Ooh, I need to. Oh, yeah, I can actually do that because. The spawns will unfreeze me. Oh, yeah, you can repair and remove the ice. But I don't want to do that because the spawn will unfreeze me anyway and I don't take any damage. Yeah, I'll teleport him here and GG. And now we are ready for the final fight and I have a good feeling about it. I like my team. It's really a strong team now. I did not think it would be like that in the beginning, but now it's really amazing. Oh, and we got a. Wow, we got a really good pilot. Move again after shooting is a very good ability. Stabilizers. No longer take damage when blocking emerging mech. Yeah, I don't care about that really. Take a pilot, maybe I'll keep him, but I don't think so. Rockman. No, I think I like that. Okay, what do we have here? Repair drop. Heal all player units, including disabled mechs. Nah, we don't need that, I hope. Shoot a projectile through a building. It's cute, but only 2 damage. Screw that. Ooh, Gemini missiles. Not bad, not bad, but I think I'm happy with my options here. It would have to be a really good thing. Astro bombs where you fly over an enemy. You know what? I have enough of that crap. I don't want to fly anymore. It's very annoying to use that, in my opinion. Let's buy 2 grid. Take that. What the hell do I do now? Does he have one more core, more reactor than the regular? Or is that that? Hmm, maybe. Okay, well, I have nothing to buy. I mean, I can give more movement is good. Yeah, more movement is always good. So maybe one more core to give the movement. And, yeah, we can't get that, of course. Okay, well, yeah. Archimedes. Do I want to use Archimedes in any way? Yeah, could put him here. And buy one more core and put it in. Now the question is the skill worth it? Move again after shooting. It's nice to get after you teleport somebody in the water, you can get back into position. It's kind of nice. But the skill is bad, I lose the HP. And having 2 HP is bad if you have the debuff Psion in the final fight and you take 1 damage every turn. That's dangerous, yeah, to only have 2 health like that. So I think I won't do that. The question is, what else do we need? I mean, we have... we might just buy Overpower Grid. It's not great, but... So you want one more core, I think. Definitely one more core. Into the movement. Alternatively, we could... Nah. I thought maybe give the tank to that guy, but I will be using a teleporter pretty much every turn. And if not, I can use that if I want some more damage. And I can't put anything here anymore. I can't put anything here anymore. I like flying. Only 3 movement is bad, but 4 health is enough. I think I'll do that. Or take the health, maybe it's... Yeah, I don't like the overpower grid. It's... whatever. Just do the... Oh, I have another weapon. Okay, let's buy that. 2%, yay. Okay. I have to remember that my tank does damage now. So I can't push my own guys like that anymore. For no damage. Let's go. Okay, a digger, scarab, a scorpion. Ugh. But we can avoid a scorpion, probably. We probably should avoid him. He's a bastard. Like that, maybe. I have good movement, with the exception of that guy. Unfortunately, well, I hope I can reach them. 5 movement, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I can maybe teleport somebody in the water. If I do it like that. Although I have a feeling it's more likely that I can teleport them here. Huh? For example, imagine a situation where he goes like here. Then I can, or here. Nah, he can only go here. So if I'm here, I can 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but I can also go here or here. It's probably better, huh? Okay, let's do it like that. I'm a bit worried about the boss. Can I reach him if he is like here? I hope I can. Like, go here and shoot him. Use the tank to push him, maybe. Let's go like that. I don't want to be prevented from moving. That's would be bad. Also, you have a volcano. It always puts instant death tiles on. Yeah, like that. Can be different. Can be here. Can be here. Can, but always near the volcano. And I didn't want to be spidered over there where I can't move. It's only lava. Yeah, okay, I can fly, right? The lava doesn't really hurt me. Won't put me on fire. So maybe I was too scared about that. Maybe I didn't need to be scared like that. But I can do my thing where I teleport him into death. I can... Oh, that's a bit nasty, actually, because I can't... Yeah, my movement is being a problem. My movement is being a problem. Shit. Now here probably we can like shoot him for 5 damage. It's pretty nice. I could teleport him here so the boss kills his own guy. Doesn't really help me in any way though. So I won't teleport the digger, but the problem is with that is that I can't really... How do I deal with a scorpion? He's gonna hit me pretty hard here. I could freeze them, to be fair, I only need to kill them. But I need a way to unfreeze. Or I lose, of course, a turn where I can't move, yeah. Which is bad. And the only guy who can get to the digger is the teleport guy. That's the only way I get to that guy. And he also damages that, which is bad. Now if he had one more movement, he could go here, shoot him, and it would be fine. But he can't, now can he? Now that's a problem, unfortunately. Alternatively, I can do that. The stone will be pushed. That guy can kill that guy, and then I push the boss, I guess. With the acid. That's probably better, actually. That's much better. But I don't know if it's much better, but it prevents damage. And that's good in my book. Oh no, it's bad. Nah. Because now if I push him, he damages. Ah, shit. God damn it, guys. He does 4 damage, that bastard. Just 4 damage. It was a good idea, it was a good plan, but it didn't quite pan out. Yeah, disgusting. I still think that might be the way to go. Can I teleport him anywhere where he is not doing damage? I can tank a shot to the face. I don't know if it's a good idea. I have 7 HP, to be fair, I mean... Yeah, but that's no good. God damn it, guys, why are you doing that to me? Like that... Teleporting him here is, makes no sense. That guy is a problem, he's not really useful here, it's a problem. Yeah, I can afford to take a little bit of damage, but... It's better if I don't, of course. Yeah, I don't want to take 4 damage to the face like that. Yeah, if I take 4 damage. Wait. Teleport him here. Yeah, maybe I got it. Okay, I deploy the tank. Push the stone will die, damage him for 1, putting him to 4 health, teleport, he kills his own guy. I think that's the play here. And I get the tank out, which is good. No, I don't have a... Yeah, okay. I got it. It's a bit nasty, but we got it. He kills him before he can attack, he attacks nothing, But three more spawns is pretty nasty. Three more spawns, man. Bruh. Brrr. Not what you want. But I have my tank out. And my tank can do damage. And now we have our gun with 5 damage. We can probably one hit the boss. If he is in the right... Oh no, blobber. Hmm. Blah, blobber. Okay, he attacks nothing. Ooh, artillery guy. Ah, that's bad. That's really bad. Now the good news is that the boss is not really attacking anything special. Which is very nice. In fact, many of them are not really doing anything special. My tank has no particularly good move because he can't go on the fire and stuff like that. He can't fly, that's the point. I could just go for ice generator. That might be the easiest, to be honest. The question is, once I do the ice generator, how do I unfreeze myself again? And I'm not sure if I can do that. I think the instant death tile is instant death. Doesn't matter if you are frozen or not. It won't. A shield won't help you, I think. Seems like a pretty reasonable assumption. So I can. If I do that, I take 4 damage. Ugh. Yeah, I don't think I want to do the freeze. Five damage. Yeah, I can't quite. I can kill him if I use my tank, but I can shoot here, take out the artillery, take out the bomb. But when I... Okay, that guy is not doing anything, to be fair. That guy is not doing anything. The annoying part is that my tank can't do much here. If I do it like that. What if I freeze myself here? That might be okay. But how do I ever unfreeze? Oh, I know how I unfreeze, okay. I have a plan here, actually. I do that. It's complicated, man, but I think I can do it. Now, I take the shot here. I freeze myself. The tank shouldn't be on that position. It's a bad idea. So take the shot here, freeze myself here, teleport. Ugh, it's complicated. Should be fine though. He hits nothing, they are frozen. I will be unfrozen, he hits nothing. Action available, yeah, nothing to do really. With my little tank. Yeah, do you remember that gun that is in a line and it does 4 damage if it's far distance? It would be completely useless here. Because there's all that crap in the way. Okay, to be fair, I could have done the shot here, yeah. But the thing I have now is much better. Because the distance doesn't really matter for that. He's gonna die, I think. He's gonna be in lava. He tries to unfreeze the boss. No, we can't really allow that. Okay, lava flow. The tile here will turn into lava, so he will, because he can't fly. Although his name is Firefly, he can't fly, and he's gonna die. Which is nice, it's fine with me. Teleport that guy into death. And I can do that. Yeah, seems fine with me. Now my tank is not doing shit. My tank is not doing anything. Also, the ice is a bit of a shield, yeah? Kind of nice. That guy will be on fire when he comes out. I can allow two spawns. Yeah, I can allow two spawns, I mean. That's okay. My tank is burning, but who cares? Goodbye. Two spawns. Ah, it's funny. No, I don't know if I die here, if our unit dies, if it's gone for the next fight. I think it's gone for the next fight. Let's try to not lose anybody here. Okay, I'm not in any bad position. So, yeah, I can push that guy here, why not? Just for fun. Yeah, okay. I'm getting back my two shots. And I learned a trick after the last time, after the disaster last time, or in my first playthrough. I have a trick up my sleeve for the last round here. Okay. Because every second turn, every tile you stand on will become an instant death tile. And if you stand on, so if you stand on a spawn, if you are on a spawn tile, it becomes an instant death tile and it will become fire and it eats up the spawn. I will show you what I mean if I can. So you can make your life much easier by that. What the hell? The bomb killed the scorpion. Did you see that? It dropped on the scorpion, that's funny. Unfortunately, I can't choose my position in this battle. So this guy is a bit of a problem, potentially. But I can, yeah, the flying is so nice, yeah, being able to fly. I can push him with the acid, and he kills that guy for me. Ooh, the digger. The digger is a bit of a bastard. But I can do that, he's gonna die. And when I go here, shoot him. Yeah, or even better. No, I thought I could get my tank out to push and then hit that guy, but there's a grid here. So that's no good. That's no good. That's no good. I take one damage from that. But who cares? I have 7 damage. I think I can allow that. He's gonna die. Okay. So, okay, I didn't do a best job of blocking spawns, but the idea is that next turn, this tile, this tile, this tile will become instant death tiles. And if you stand on a spawn, the spawn will become an instant death tile. And what happens next turn after that is that tentacles turn this, or it will turn into lava, and the spawn will disappear in the lava, and you have one less enemy to deal with. So theoretically, if I stand here, here, and here, I have 3 less enemies to deal with in 2 turns. Really valuable. I'll show you what I mean here in a moment. So that guy will kill his buddy. Yeah. That's the spirit. Okay, so that became instant death tiles, right? And it's also a spawn tile. And this will become lava. Not only a rock will drop here. Yeah, see here, tentacles, right? On the right button, you can read. The unit here will die and the tile will turn into lava. And the spawn will also disappear. And that's one less enemy to deal with. So, good to know. Okay, oh, but guy is threatening my my thing. Now I can't push that guy into the lava. I can even, no, I can't go here, but that's okay. I can use a teleport, the boss will die. Wait, the unit here will die, right? It won't only turn into lava, it will also die. It's very clear on that. It's important because if I'm wrong about that, my guy will die from the boss. We don't really want that. Now I could use my freeze and that would be okay. Maybe I should. But I don't have to. Yeah, it's fun to use that. And nah, maybe I save that, you know. Just, yeah. Not sure. Trying to find the best way to do that. I want to get my tank out if I can. I can get my tank out. I can just push him out of the way. Now that enemy is not hard to deal with, yeah. Just push him out of the way and deal 2 damage also. I think I'll do that like that. Unfortunately, I can't push him in an instant death tile. Yeah, that's a shame. So he will die, I hope. I sincerely hope that. Worst case, he will be in lava and he can't attack. Yeah, okay. Now see, the spawn got eaten by the tentacles. The spawn is gone, and the spawn is an enemy that's gone. It's really good. Okay, now I should be able to deal with that. Okay, again, a rock will fall here, killing any unit. I have 3 enemies. Can make him charge in the lava. Okay, I think I have a good, fairly good plan here to deal with all of that crap. He will charge in the lava. He is dead, and here I block a spawn, maybe. I don't think there's a rock gonna drop here, but it's a bit close for comfort. I'll just stay here, okay? That should be... Yeah, I could have went here. Oh, good to know that the rock turns the lava tiles into normal tiles again. And like I mentioned, if you remember, in my first playthrough, I wondered on the last turn if the tentacles killed my bomb, but no, they don't attack the bomb. As you can see here quite clearly, ground tile, no special effect. My bomb died because of a Psion, which did 1 damage to it. At the end of a turn, I missed that, I forgot that that debuff did damage to the bomb, I didn't remember, or I didn't realize that my bomb only had 1 HP, so I lost the game in the last turn. Completely bullshit, not bullshit, it was my fault really, but yeah. Very heartbreaking. And just to be extra sure, I could push the bomb, but I know that it's fine, nothing will happen. Okay, there's no enemy, that's nice. And we won the game, holy shit. It's funny, yeah, the team in the beginning was weaker than the team I failed with. Why did my guy die? What the hell? No! Yeah, okay, that's normal, yeah. We have to go to another timeline. But we won the game. pretty convincingly in the end, I might add. But it's fun, I like playing random teams, that's, I find that very enjoyable. Yeah, turning a weak team or a average team into a really real powerhouse. In the end, my team was really strong. I lost a bit of grit along the way, but okay, so that was the playthrough. And yeah, next time I think we'll do another random chaos roll and random pilot. And but now I got her, and there are two more that you can find in the same way, and I haven't found them yet. Okay, well, thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll be back.